Good morning, children. I welcome to the first online class after summer break. I hope all must have done their holiday homework. Children, if you have not completed your holiday homework, kindly complete your holiday homework. And today is the first online video. So in this video, while watching the video, you must keep your books and notebooks along with you. Like in class, you are holding one pencil and underlining the important lines. Here also, while watching the video, you should underline the important lines. And some activities also in the video we are completing. I am explaining some activity and answers. You, while watching the video, you can complete those answers. So let's start. Today I will explain you about Windows 7. File navigation and file manipulation. So let's start. File navigation and file manipulation, how to create a file, how to create a folder, how to copy, how to rename, and Windows Explorer, desktop screen, everything I will explain you in today's video. So let's begin Windows. File navigation and manipulation. So see, this is Windows screen, Windows 7. Chapter name is Windows 7, how to file navigate, how to do manipulation in Windows 7. I will explain you. So what is Windows 7? Windows 7 is an operating system. So how to do file navigation and manipulation in Windows 7, I will explain you. So see, this is the desktop screen. Whenever you will start your computer, you must have seen this type of desktop screen. The first screen that we see is known as desktop screen. So what is a desktop? Desktop is the first screen. Whenever we switch on the computer, the first screen that appears on Windows is called desktop. So the word desktop relates the real life desktop. All the utility items are placed. In desktop, small pictures or icons are placed. They are known as pictures or icons. So Windows 7 desktop, operating system, taskbar, window, icon, everything. So this is the desktop screen and this is the shortcut menu. When you will click on the shortcut menu, you can open new file, folder or anything over here. So elements of the Windows 7 desktop. So these are known as icons and the programs button for Internet Explorer, Microsoft Word. W is written W for Microsoft Word, E Internet Explorer. This is my computer. So these are icons. This is the taskbar. The bottom bar is known as taskbar. This is the notification area, recycle bin. This is the desktop. Desktop picture in your computer, desktop picture may be different, and these are the gadgets, desktop gadgets, clock, CPU, meter, alarm clock, then currency. These are all desktop gadget. When you right click on a desktop, you can get the desktop gadget. So these are desktop icon. This is the start button, four color, different color. This is the start button. This is the programs button. You can see programs button, taskbar. This is the desktop. This is the notification area and this is the desktop gadgets. Now whenever you want to start any program, you click on the start button and this is the start menu. Suppose you want to start MS Word, you will click on MS Word and you will start. So this is desktop wallpaper and this is internet. E stands for Internet Explorer. This is my computer. This is my document. This one is recycle bin and my network placeholder. So this is my network. This is recycle bin and this is my documents. So this are the parts of the Windows screen. Again, same thing, my computer is like this, my computer, this is recycle bin, Internet Explorer, start button, and this is the active application. Suppose you want to open any application, file edit, you will go to my documents and you want to search any application. So this is active application. In this way, you must have seen in your home also, you must be having this type of desktop screen, and you can do, this is known as system area or notification area. Now Windows Explorer, this is Windows Explorer, this one is backward button, this one is forward, this one is backward button, this is forward button, this is toolbar, this is address bar, this one is search box. Suppose you want to search for a particular file or anything, or in, then you can type here search box, and this is the maximize, minimize and close button. These are the maximize, minimize and close button. This is the navigation pane. You can see this are is navigation pane. These are scroll bar, horizontal and vertical scroll bar, files and folders. This is a folder. You can see this is a folder. You can keep inside the folder, you can keep your files, and this are the details pane. You can write all the details. So Windows Explorer is powerful, easy to use tool for viewing or working with files or folders. It gives a complete overview of all the folders. You can see it gives a complete overview of all the folders and files on the computer, and also give more information and control over their contents. You can start Windows Explorer in several ways, like click start all programs, accessories, then Windows Explorer to open Windows Explorer, and you will get this type of screen. All this file, folders, everything you will get. Now arrow pick and arrow snap, two features are there. Arrow features in Windows 7. Arrow snap, dragging in Windows to the left or right edges of the desktop. Arrow snap features offers a quick and easy way to snap, to switch Windows into the left or right half of your screen. You can see this one, two windows are there. By dragging the windows to the edges, can also snap windows vertically. Arrow pick to quickly peer the past all open windows, to look straight at the Windows 7 desktop, simply point to the right edge of the text bar. All open windows will turn transparent, making what's on the desktop. So arrow snap, how to start arrow snap? Dragging the window to the left and right edge of your desktop will cause half of the screen. Dragging a window to the top edge of the screen, you can maximize till the whole screen. How to use the steps? Place the cursor at the top of the window, then drag left or right of the screen and wait to the transparent window to appear, then let go. To return to the full view, snap the window to the top of the full screen. So this is the step you can do arrow snap. So this arrow snap, arrow features are in Windows 7. Arrow snap, arrow pick and arrow shake. One feature is there. In that arrow shake feature, when your desktop is cluttered with open windows, suppose you have opened so many windows, you can use arrow shake features to select a single window and close the rest. So the steps are, you can click on the window you want to focus on, keeping the left mouse button pressed and shake your mouse, the rest of the window will disappear. Simply shake the window again and close window till appear. You can flip the windows also, switch from one window to other window. Now files, folders. What is a file? What is a folder in window? So what is a file? You must have seen in your day-to-day life, you are from nursery to class 8, you must be keeping your all certificate marksheets inside a file. So file where you can keep your collection of important things. We store our important things inside a file. The Windows operating system provides easy to use methods and tools to manage and organize the data files created by user. The files created by the user, it very easy method you can keep your things. We can store the data files in any of the secondary storage devices like the data files created by, like hard disk, pen drive, CD drive or DVD. Data files in each drive can be further organized into separate folders. You can further keep those one in separate folders, and files can be easily copied and removed. So what is a file? File is a collection of information. Any type of data or information stored in a computer is in the form of file. There are different types of files, including operating system file, application program file, different types of data files created in different software. Each file is given a file name and has a file name extension and identifies the file type. The file name and extension, each file has a file name and extension, like you are having your name and surname. So each file has a file name and extension, and file name and extension are separated by a dot. For example, document creating MS Word has the file name letter.docx. Some of the common file name are given, extension are given here: docx, Word or WordPad document, .eml, email file, htm or html, html file, accdb, access database, txt, notepad text file, xlsx, excel spreadsheet, pptx, powerpoint presentation. So these are the file name extension of any file you will create in Word, Excel or PowerPoint. These are the file name extension. Folder, you are keeping your things, because lots of file if you will create, it is very difficult to identify which folder. So you will make a folder in your name and keep all the files inside that folder. So folder is a container you can use to store or organize files in a computer. If you have large number of files of different types on your computer, it would be really impossible to find any particular file when you need it. That is why people often organize file in different folders. Folders have typical icons below. I have shown you in the diagram PDF folders, one notebook folders, Visual Studio, though this type of folder. A folder can also store other folder inside it. Folder contained inside other folder is called subfolder. You can create any number of subfolders, and each can hold number of files and additional subfolders. Disk drive, like different types of disk drives are there. The term disk driver, so the floppy disk drive or hard disk drive. So disk drive refers to a storage device where you can store, storage device of the computer where the files and folders are stored. Drivers represent by an alphabet followed by a colon. For example, hard disk drive referred as C drive, USB drive referred as F drive, and G drive. DVD or CD drive is referred as E drive. The location where a file is stored depends upon the drive you choose in Save As dialog box while saving it. Remember, all software are generally installed in C drive. You can view all the storage devices drives in the computer window. So this type of drives you can store. So what is, I have told you what is file, folder. Now I will tell you how you can create a file, folder and everything. So before starting how to create file, folder and everything, deleting basic Windows tool. Paint is the basic Windows tool. So you must have seen paint, and everyone must have worked on paint using different brushes. So paint is an important program in Windows 7 accessories menu. We can use it to draw, color and edit pictures. We can use paint like digital sketchbook to make simple pictures, greeting cards, add text or design to other pictures, such as those taken with digital camera. How to start paint? I am not going to explain. I think everyone must be knowing. Next, Notepad. Notepad is the basic text editing program on Windows 7. Go to File, New, then Text Editor, Notepad. Calculator is also a program where you can do the calculation. Now, practically how to copy, edit, delete everything, I will explain you. So now, students, I will explain you how you can create a file or folder. So this is the desktop screen. You can see this is the desktop screen. Right click here, then new option is there. Click on new, then folder. Now see, this is a folder has been created. You can create a folder like this. Suppose you want to give any name, you can give computer. I want to give computer folder. In this way, you can create a file or folder. Now again, if you want to rename the file or folder, what you will do? You will click on this icon, right click, then rename. Rename option is there. Then you can rename anything. You can see different options are here: open, share with, then send to, cut, copy, delete, rename. So I will click here rename, then you can rename. Suppose I want to write class 9th, then you can rename. In this way, we can rename a file or folder. So how to create a file folder understood, how to rename a file and folder understood. Now I want to delete this file and folder. So I will click delete option. Now the folder has been deleted. So in this way, you can delete a file, folder and rename files and folders. Now suppose already I want to restore some file and folder. Go to recycle bin. I have clicked on the recycle bin. Suppose this files and folders I have deleted, and all the files and folders, whatever you have deleted, is kept inside the recycle bin for temporarily. Suppose permanently you want to delete, then you have to delete, click delete option from here. And suppose you want to restore it by mistake, suppose you have deleted any file and folder little, then later on you want that file and folder, then you have to click the restore button to get those file and folder. So in this way, we can get the file and folder. Clear? So students, I have explained you about how to create file and folder, and how you can, this is the network icon, this is the control panel, this is the recycle bin icon, this is the PC personal. You can change the settings or control panel, or you can change the screen saver or anything. Suppose you want to move any file or folder, so you can simply drag and move. We can move a file or folder by copying and pasting also. You can drag a file or folder, copying a file or folder. So right click any folder or file, click on copy button, then anywhere. Suppose you want to paste somewhere else, then you click on paste button, the file folder will be saved. Suppose I want to paste here, then I will click paste button. So in this way, we can copy a file or folder, or paste or file and folder. Now already two file folders I have created, so I don't want this folder, so I will press delete button. I have deleted the folder. So the folder has been deleted. In this way, you can create a file or folder, you can copy a file or folder, or you can delete a file or folder. So today I have explained you how you can, in Windows 7, you can navigate file folder, you can copy file folder, you can rename file folder, and you can move a file folder. So that's all for